Shalom, dearest brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome to this week's episode of Midweek With The Saints. It's good to be back with all of you. I hope all of you had a meaningful, hope-filled, spirit-filled Christmas. And I would like to wish all of you a blessed New Year. As we start this New Year from the outset, let us look to the life of Jesus. Let us look to the life of the saints who inspire us to rise unto sainthood in Christ Jesus. You know, St. Paul says he imitates Christ and he asks his followers in his letters to imitate him. We imitate Jesus, we imitate the saints who have gone before us so that we can rise in sanctity, in holiness, and in greatness, with zeal and passion. Friends, before I dive into the saint for this week, I would like to ask all of you to click on the like, subscribe, follow buttons, whether you're following on YouTube, Spotify, or Instagram, as well as to just share this podcast with whomever you believe can benefit from it. Be it Catholics, Christians, non-Catholics, Christians, non-believers, just share it with them so that they can come to encounter Jesus Christ. This week, we're going to take a look at the life of Saint Pedro Calungsod. Saint Pedro Calungsod is a patron saint for youth, catechists, and he's also a martyr. Saint Pedro Calungsod died at the young age of 17. And as I said earlier, he was a catechist. He followed a priest on mission to Guam with other missionaries. They went and preached the gospel explicitly to non-believers. They baptized in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And he preached the gospel of Jesus Christ with zeal and enthusiasm. He preached on the catechism of the Catholic Church with much zeal and enthusiasm. He was a passionate saint. Brothers and sisters in Christ, all of us were made to be passionate. We're made to be passionate for God, for our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We're made to be passionate, to go all out, to run to Him, and to run to Him to get the strength to share His good news with others, to share His gospel, to share His catechism, the heart of the church with others. We were made to be passionate. Whether or not we channel that passion in the right way, to be passionate for God or to be passionate for other things, we were made to be passionate. And Saint Pedro Calungsod was one who was definitely passionate. The priest who decided to take him along, wanted to take him along, a young lay missionary, because he wanted the young people in Guam to be inspired by his sense of contagious holiness, his sense of love for the Catholic faith, his firm groundedness on the Catholic faith and the Catholic teachings, and his love for Jesus. And that was truly what drew so many people in Guam to the Catholic faith. You know, Saint Pedro Calungsod, who was handpicked by this priest to follow, ended up dying first before the priest, ended up being a martyr even before the priest. St. Pedro Calungsod preached the gospel explicitly to people in villages across Guam. And in this one particular village where he and the priest were preaching, there was this opposition from a certain man, who went in turn to hire a killer. And this killer came with his spear and he started aiming the spears at Pedro Calungsod. And Pedro Calungsod was a young 17-year-old. He managed to athletically dodge all the spears that were being aimed at him. And eyewitnesses say that this was amazing. If only Pedro Calungsod had his own weapons, he could have probably defeated the opposition. But of course, in Christianity, in Catholicism, in the life of Christ, we never resort to violence. And because St. Pedro Calungsod wanted to remain with the priest whom he was accompanying, he ended up being killed. The spear poked through his chest, pierced through his chest. And in his dying moments, the priest who was behind him, beside him, with him, the priest whom he was trying to protect, gave him his final absolution. And he died as a martyr for the Catholic faith. Friends, this is what Pedro Calungsod, a 17-year-old, did when he left his home country, Philippines. He's a patron saint for all of you who are watching from the Philippines. He's a patron saint for all of us from Asia, all of us Asian men to rise up. He left his country, Philippines. He went to Guam, to a land that he don't know about, with a priest and other missionaries, and he preached, and he died for the faith. And because he died for the faith could grow in Guam. The church grew in Guam. The blood of the martyrs is the seed of the church. And his fellow companions, upon hearing that he had passed away before the priest passed away right after Pedro passed away, he was killed as well. But in finding out that Pedro passed away first, they were like, how blessed that this young lay missionary, fellow lay missionary of ours, was granted the privilege to go before even the priest who was leading us. What a privilege to be a martyr for Christ. What a privilege to rise up and to be the source for growth of the church in a certain place. Brothers and sisters in Christ, in reflecting on the story of St. Pedro Calungsod, I had to do a reality check. He died for the faith at the age of 17 because he was so in love with Jesus and he was so in love with the Catholic faith that he studied the catechism thoroughly and he shared it, and he was willing to die sharing it to others because this is what matters the most at the end of the day. Friends, when I was 17 years old, I reflect, there's one regret that I have in hindsight, that I did not preach the gospel explicitly to those that I was close to in my high school. And this in particular applies to my deskmate. When I was 17 in high school, my final year in high school, I had this deskmate whom I was very close to. And right before our major examinations, when we had our trial examinations about 3 months before the actual examinations, this classmate of mine, this deskmate of mine, this dear friend and brother of mine, passed away in a freak accident. And in hindsight, I have much regret that I never once preached the gospel to him, be it directly or indirectly using my words. I never once told him about the gospel of Jesus Christ. And because of that, I do not know where his soul is today. Friends, there is much regret that even after I experienced a life-changing miracle at the age of 14, I had everything at my disposal to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ explicitly to my friends, to my peers. But instead, I shied away. I had discerned the will of God. I had decided that I want to share the gospel for Jesus when I was 14. When 14, 15, 16, 17 years passed, and I never acted on what I discerned and decided to do. I never acted on it. I never truly rose up with boldness and courage, with passion like St. Pedro Calungsod, who was so passionate for the gospel and for the catechism, to share with my non-believing or non-Christian and Catholic friends. By the age of 17. You know, friends, there was much regret in me when I started to reflect on this, and much despair and sorrow as well. If only I had preached to him, he would have accepted Jesus as his Lord and Savior. He might have accepted Jesus as his Lord and Savior and made it to heaven. But because I did not do that, I do not know where he is. And I do not know the rest of my classmates as well. But friends, moving on from there, God inspired me to just move on from the past. There are far greater things ahead than we leave behind. Satan will tempt us to wallow in guilt and self-pity. Why didn't I do that? Woe is me. But the Spirit says, now you have learned your lesson. Go on, press on. Preach the gospel to those that you're supposed to preach to. And after my high school days, in my pre-university, in my university days, even up till today, I preach the gospel. I sow the seed and I leave the job for conversion to the Holy Spirit. Brothers and sisters in Christ, let us rise up like Pedro Calungsod. We cannot say that we are too young. Pedro Calungsod died at the young age of 17 for the faith. In previous weeks, last month, we saw the lives of St. Anna Wang, who died even younger. We can never be too young to die for the faith. We can never be too young to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ to our friends, to our families, who are non-believers, non-Catholics or non-Christians. Let us bring the gospel of Jesus Christ with passion. Passion that is so convincing that people will say, I want what you have. Whatever it is that you have, it is giving you that joy, that peace, that love, that is giving you that sense of radiance around your face whenever we come across you. What is it? And when that moment comes, you can say that this is the joy of the Lord. And friends, let us preach the gospel explicitly with our words. Let us just sow the seeds of the gospel of Jesus Christ, the word of God, so that people can come to encounter Jesus in spirit and in truth. Brothers and sisters in Christ, let us pray. St. Pedro Calungsod, at the young age of 17, you rose up. You became a saint and a martyr. You were a young and athletic man who could have escaped death, but you chose to stand by your priest whom you were accompanying, and you ended up being a martyr for the Catholic faith, which ended up being the seed for the conversion of many souls in Guam, many souls in Philippines, many souls in Asia. Saint Pedro, help us to rise up. Help us not to give excuses. We are too young, we are too old, we are too fat, we are too thin. Saint Pedro, help us to look beyond ourselves, beyond our age, beyond our linguistic barriers, beyond our physique, beyond our weaknesses, and help us to look to Christ where our strength is, so that we can rise up with boldness, with faith, with enthusiasm. And Saint Pedro Calungsod, help us to rediscover the richness of truth found in and through only the Catholic Church, the Catechism of the Catholic Church. Through your intercessions, through your mighty intercessions, grant us the grace to perceive the Word of God, to study Scripture, to study the Catechism of the Catholic Church, to memorize them, and most importantly, to be able to articulate these thoughts, to be able to live them out, to be able to talk about them and share about them in very practical ways, so that people can come to believe in Jesus Christ, whether they are existing as Catholics as of now, whether they are non-Catholics, non-Christians, or non-believers even. Whoever it is that we come across, Saint Pedro, grant us the grace, the boldness to die to ourselves, to die to our ego, to die to our pride, to die to our sense of doubt, to die to our selfishness, and to just share the faith with them. Even if it means that they will persecute us, even if it means that they will shout at us, they may say all sorts of words against us, but help us to just sow the seed for conversion in their hearts. Help us to bring more people into the Catholic faith, Saint Pedro. We seek your intercessions at the start of this year. We, the youth who are watching, seek your intercessions at the start of this year. This year, 2021, Saint Pedro, grant us this through your intercessions the grace to preach the gospel explicitly throughout the countries that we are in, throughout Asia, throughout the rest of this world. And to the ends of the world, Saint Pedro, we seek your intercessions. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Brothers and sisters in Christ, thank you all for tuning in today. Let us continue to look to Saint Pedro Calungsod for inspiration. For all of us in Philippines, for all of us in Malaysia, for all of us in Singapore, neighboring countries, Southeast Asia, we have a saint whom we can call homegrown, whom we can say comes from our continent. We have a saint for youths, we have a saint who has gone before us and showed us the example. Someone who was so in love with Jesus. Let us continue to look up to him, look for his intercessions, and rise up to great levels of sainthood in Christ Jesus. See you all next week. God bless.